click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have talked about how can we determine the molecular structure of ammonia. And now based on that theory only, that is based on VSEPR theory only, we are going to determine that what would be the structure of, or the molecular structure of that of water. So let us talk about it. So now what we are going to do is we are determining the molecular structure of water using VSEPR theory. But in water, as we know, that water consists of basically oxygen as the central atom. So that is the reason that we are now going to discuss about the electronic configuration of oxygen first, and then we will move to the further part. So talking about the oxygen, oxygen is the one which has an atomic number of 8. So I have represented it here as atomic number of 8, and the electronic configuration can be written as 1s2, 2s2 and 2p4. So this is what we have. So let us understand that we should express, that is the subshells also, and we have at the outermost shell, we are talking about the valence shell, and the valence shell consists of S subshell as well as P subshell. But S subshell has only one orbital, while the P subshell consists of basically three orbitals, that is what I am going to mention over here. And now let us fulfill the electrons, and in this case we will get to know that is, since we are talking about the ground state, so therefore the two electrons that are present in the S orbital, that is four electrons are present in, that is P orbital, that is 1, 2, 3, and let me discuss about the fourth one also, and here it is suppose Px, Py, and suppose it is Pz. But during the formation of the bond between the oxygen and hydrogen, obviously we know that the hydrogen is being involved so as to form that is a bond with that of the unpaired electron of the oxygen and again the unpaired electron of oxygen. So that means two hydrogens are being involved so as to form bond with that of oxygen. So now if I would say that what would be the hybridization for this one, so it is very easy to understand. Suppose if this is the one that we have, and in this case basically overall the hybridization also in the topic where we have discussed about the hybridization of water, in that case also we have got to know that is the oxygen is the one which is following, that is sp3 hybridization, and that's the reason because of which a water has a different shape compared to that of an unexpected one. So let us talk about the water, and in this case, but before starting with the water, and we know that hydrogen is the one which has one electron in its outermost shell, and that is how we can represent the orbital of that also. So this is what we have, and it consists of basically one electron, that is this one. So basically we need basically two hydrogen molecules. So I will write it over here that we need two electrons we need two hydrogen atoms, each of which consists of one electron, and that one electron will get occupied over here, and so as to it will form bonding over here with opposite spin, and here also. So making a total of, basically we could get the hybridization as follows that I'm going to talk about, and that is for this one, that is for formation of water molecule. So now we are going to talk about that is the electron pairs, and since I have, if I am talking about that is the 2s orbital over here, and this is the 2s orbital of the central, because we are in VSEPR theory, we are basically focusing on the central atom over here, and the rest of the p orbitals are being present over here in this way. So that is it. But now let us fulfill the electrons, and this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 valence electrons were there for the oxygen. But meanwhile, when we are talking about hydrogen, so hydrogen consists of only one unpaired electron, and that is what I will fill it over here. So making this to be total of, basically in this case, basically how many pair of electrons that I could see? I could see the pair of electrons at S, which is basically the valence electron, valence which is belong to the valence shell, S and 3 types of P orbital. So therefore, I could say that this is basically where I could say Px, Py and Pz are being involved. So ultimately I am getting basically sp3 hybridized structure of water. So if it is sp3 hybridized structure, then similar to that of what we have got in methane, methane is the one which is basically is giving us pure sp3 hybridized structure without any distortion in their angle. So we get 109 degree and 28 minutes. But what about water? So water consists of basically two lone pair of electrons that we could see, that is present on the oxygen atom. So that is the reason that that will have an effect on the shape of the, or the molecular geometry of the water. So the expected shape is what we could get, or expected geometry, that is what we could get as tetrahedral. But meanwhile, when you are talking about the expected angle, so the expected angle or the bond angle that I am talking about here in this case, it is being found to be that is 109 degree 28 minutes. So this is the expected one. But is it actually the same thing where we could see that the water molecule has a bond angle of 109 degree 28 minutes? No, it is not. Let me give you an information over here also. That is, suppose if I draw the structure of oxygen over here. So suppose the oxygen is the one which is present in the middle. And since we are talking that it would be present in that of a tetrahedral shape. So let me tell you that suppose the two hydrogens are over here. And there will be a lone pair of electrons above it and below it. But since it consists of lone pair of electrons and even that are responsible for basically for repulsion between the lone pair and the bond pair. So obviously the both of the electrons, they will mutually, basically they will repel with each other too, as well as they can repel the bond electrons also that are been because of the oxygen's valence electron or valence, oxygen's bond electron and that of the hydrogen bond electron. So obviously here we could see that there are two lone pair of electrons, as you would see over here, that is one is of this one and another is of this one. So they will have an effect on the hydrogen bond and hydrogen bond electrons, and that's how we could see that in spite of like that we have did in the previous lecture, that is for nitrogen, nitrogen has only one unpaired electron and even that has an affected or they that has affected the bond angle of it. But now it has basically two bond unpaired electrons, and obviously this two will also have an effect on the bond angle. So what happens is the expected it has been found to be that is 109 degree and 28 minutes, but because of what? Because of the repulsion between the lone pair and this bond pair, we could see that the bond angle of water is basically found to be 104 degree 35 minutes. So this for the actual bond angle, it has been found to be 104 degree 35 minutes. And talking about the geometry or talking about the shape, that is what I am going to talk about here. So this shape is basically a V shape, as you could see over here. So basically this is a V shape molecule. When you have hydrogen, we have got to know that is the shape or the shape of the water is basically, or geometry of the water is basically found to be tetrahedral, and that is what it is clearing in the hybridization. But when we see in the form of that is VSEPR theory, again we can get a V shape and there and it has been present in a plane, and that is how we can give the geometry or we can give the shape of the water molecule using VSEPR theory. So it gives a very good detail about the bond angles also and why the bond angle is getting reduced. So this all details are given by the VSEPR theory. So that is what I want to talk about. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly and you have got to know various information about this, and I hope you will share this video with friends, and don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.